Hi guys, hope you're all staying safe and keeping well. With this video, we'll quickly run past you all a short case study on treatment of depreciation after revaluation of an item of property, plant, and equipment under the Ind AS framework. Ind AS framework, as we all know, is the commonly used term for the company's Indian accounting standards rules 2015 as amended from time to time. So in this case, the company is following revaluation model for an item of property, plant and equipment, which it revalues every 3 years. Based on the revaluation model, the company accounted for the increase in the carrying amount of asset on account of revaluation in other comprehensive income and accumulated in equity under the heading of revaluation surplus. Depreciation before revaluation was 10 rupees per annum and post revaluation it increased to 15 rupees per annum. Now the issue under discussion is what will be the correct accounting treatment for the depreciation charge after the revaluation. Should the company recognize the entire depreciation charge of 15 rupees in the statement of profit and loss and transfer 5 rupees from revaluation surplus to retained earnings in other equity, 5 rupees being the excess depreciation on account of revaluation? Or should the company recognize the pre-revaluation depreciation charge, which is 10 rupees, in the statement of profit and loss and directly adjust 5 rupees against revaluation surplus in other equity? Before we proceed further, please note that this case study ignores the impact of deferred tax accounting, for which a separate video will be uploaded. This is to keep the video short and focused. As the question is on accounting of an item of property, plant and equipment, the appropriate accounting standard under the Ind AS framework to study and apply in this case will be Ind AS 16. On your screens, you can see the definition of depreciable amount as per paragraph 6 of Ind AS 16. Depreciable amount is the cost of an asset or other amount substituted for cost less its residual value, which means that depreciable amount is the revalued amount for an item of property, plant and equipment that is subsequently measured on revaluation model. Depreciation is also defined in paragraph 6 of Ind AS 16 as the systematic allocation of the depreciable amount. Therefore, in the given case, depreciation is 15 rupees and not 10 rupees. Paragraph 48 of Ind AS 16 states that the depreciation charge for each period shall be recognized in profit or loss unless it is included in the carrying amount of another asset. In the given case, the depreciation charge is not to be included in carrying amount of any other asset. Here is what paragraph 41 states. The revaluation surplus included in equity in respect of an item of property, plant and equipment may be transferred directly to retained earnings when the asset is derecognized. This may involve transferring the whole of the surplus when the asset is retired or disposed of. Now here comes the relevant part. However, some of the surplus may be transferred as the asset is used by an entity. In such a case, the amount of the surplus transferred would be the difference between depreciation based on the revalued carrying amount of the asset and depreciation based on the asset's original cost. Transfers from revaluation surplus to retained earnings are not made through profit or loss. So guys, the conclusion that we draw from what we just discussed is that the asset must continue to be depreciated after the revaluation, but following the revaluation, the depreciable amount will undergo a change. The depreciation charge on the revalued asset will therefore be different from the depreciation that would have been charged based on the asset's historical cost less any accumulated depreciation. But Ind AS 16 requires the entire depreciation charge to be taken to the statement of profit and loss, which in the given case is 15 rupees. However, the standard permits a transfer to be made of an amount equal to the excess depreciation on account of revaluation from the revaluation surplus to the retained earnings. The standard clearly prohibits making any such transfer through profit or loss. The journal entries to be passed in this case are right here on your screens. Friends, we hope you liked this video. Please subscribe to Gap Advisors for more such videos. Thank you. Happy learning.